Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about fibromatosis early imaging. Technology benign fibrosis of sternum cleidomastoid muscle, most common cervical mass of infant, postulated to be due to birth trauma, peripartum injury in utero compartment syndrome or mild development. Most common signs and symptoms: painless palpable muscle torticollis, contralateral occipital pattern, plagiocephaly is common, history of breast presentation of typical vaginal birth is common but not mandatory. Another sign and symptom is severe orthosis, may result in limited range of movement and legs, and facial asymmetry. A newborn infant, peak presentation at 24 days old. Classical notice less than age peak of age but may worsen in first 2-3 months of life. 6. Male affected slightly more often than female. Epidemiology occur with 0.4% of liver associated with breast presentation and birth dysplasia. Imaging often diagnosis clinically without imaging. For the signs, modality of choice if imaging is required. Process is entirely intramuscular without local invasion or inflammatory change. Pusiform expansion of central sternocleidomastoid muscle. Ribald heterogeneous of lesion. Ribald internal vascularity within or about mass. No associated adenopathy calcification. Extramuscular edema and substance hemorrhage of fluid collection. Facial plan around sternocleidomastoid muscle reserve. This is a next iteration of mastocytosis with the left ear close to the left shoulder and the chin slightly turned away. No bony anomaly are seen to explain this next portion in this picture. Infant with fibromatosis coli, mild buckling of the trachea at the thoracic inlet is normal in young infant. This is the ultrasound image in a 24-day-old pathologically show of quite large external fibromatosis. Compared to the rise, typical of fibromatosis coli. This is the color of the sound, color Doppler of the sound. So the enlarged of sternocleidomastoid muscle has mildly increased blood flow and slightly increased heterogeneous necrosis syndrome. Contrast intensity in infant with facial anomaly, so homogeneous thickening of right sternocleidomastoid muscle, which lies just superficial to the jugular and carotid fascia. Fibromatosis coli can appear much more heterogeneous than this. Still, I'm in an infant with obvious torticollis, so heterogeneously increased signal depth intensity and thickness of the left sternocleidomastoid muscle, consistent with fibromatosis coli, not a normal right sternocleidomastoid muscle. Treatment: physical therapy to encourage full range of motion and stretch Steno cladding muscle mass 90% have fully recovery with conservative treatment and or physiotherapy. Surgery is only indicated in unusual case when granular vessel asymmetry or refractory lytic which persists then persists after 1 year. Thank you.